Welcome to How to Code Reading Behaviors with Running Records. I'm your host, Dr. Julie Webb, and creator of Lecentric.com. Now, we're going to take a look in this short video series at the 9 most common running record codes that you can use to better understand your students' reading behavior and start to better understand how they're processing text. Now, even if you're new to running records, or maybe you're an old hat, sorry for using the word old, maybe you're a veteran, experienced teacher with running records, even so, it's great to have a quick review, and there's a resource that I have available for you that you're going to want to download today. So stick around to the end of the video and I'll tell you more about it. All right, in this video, we're going to be talking about substitutions. Now, I bet you've heard students read, read books before, and all of a sudden they come to a word and they just throw a word in there to kind of substitute for the one that's actually supposed to be read. Now, we can analyze those substitutions and understand a lot about what a student's doing and maybe what they're not doing so well. And it's important to know how to code substitutions correctly because they are full of really important information that we're going to need. So before we get started, though, I want to make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel and click that little bell up in the corner of your screen so that you get notified every time a new video drops into Lecentric's YouTube page. All right, let's get started with substitutions. So here's our simple sentence here that we're going to use to demonstrate substitution coding. Now, we've talked about before, we need to use check marks or tick marks above every word that's read correctly. But in this case, we know we're going to make a mistake. And we're going to make a mistake here on this word like. We're going to substitute a different word. So the student reads along, and instead of saying we like to play, the student says we look to play. So here we're going to code it correctly with a tick mark. When they get to like, they say look. So we draw that line separating the student behavior from the text and the teacher behavior, and we actually write in the word that the student said. So instead of like, they said look. So we're going to actually write the full word there, exactly how the student said it, and they continue reading to and play. So here's what a substitution can look like. We have exactly what the student said. We delineate the student area from the text and teacher area. And later, when we take a look at this running record, we can understand a little bit about how this student processed this word and maybe where they made their mistakes. If you take a look here, look at that letter L. They both start with the same letter and the same sound. That's something that a beginning reader in particular might make a mistake about. Also, we've got another letter in common here that is the same letter and again, the same sound. And even these two words are the same length. They both have 4 letters. So also the fact that they're high frequency words, there's so many things actually that these words have in common that we can understand a little bit about maybe why that student made that mistake. And we can also understand maybe how we can help them differentiate those words in the future. Now, I promised you a downloadable resource. In the comments below, there's a link to Running Record Bootcamp. That's the online course that I designed, and man, it's the course I wish I would have had when I started teaching years and years ago. Instead of piecing together information from all these different places, way before we even had YouTube, yes, I'm that old, we didn't have YouTube when I started teaching, it was really hard to figure out, am I doing running records correctly? Am I analyzing them? Am I getting the full benefit out of them? Because they're a big time investment, and I wanted to make sure I was doing it well, and I wanted to develop my expertise as a teacher, and that's what Running Record Bootcamp is designed to do. Now, even if you've never done a running record before, in Running Record Bootcamp, I've got a specially designed practice opportunity for you where we go through a simplified text at a speed that we can handle so that we can practice some of the most common codes that we use. And not only that, you're going to get feedback on exactly what a master-coded running record looks like so you can compare the things that you tried to the actual correct version. And that's a great way for you to start understanding the codes that maybe are coming easier for you and maybe ones that are a little bit harder. And for those of you who've done running records before, it never hurts to practice because you know you always have students every year who present differently than all the other years. And so getting a better understanding of running records and getting really fluent with your coding will help you be a better reading teacher. Now, I promised you a resource. So if you click in the comments below to that Running Record Bootcamp page, there's some downloads in there. There's some videos that you can watch. You can get a sense of what the course looks like. And you can see all the different lessons in the course. You can understand if it's a good fit for you. But there's a download in there I want you to go get right now for yourself. It's Litcentric Common Codes Cheat Sheet. And that cheat sheet has the 9 codes that we're talking about in this video series, as well as what those codes can actually mean for your reader. Because if a student's doing a behavior like this, where they're substituting things a lot, we need to know maybe why they're doing that and what to do about it. And the cheat sheet's gonna help us with that information. So click that link below, take a look at Running Record Bootcamp, and make sure you grab your copy of the cheat sheet today. All right, that's all we have for substitutions. Have a great day at school.